Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala, amma ba'd. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Everyone, we welcome you to another episode of Morning Tea, Talaqqi and Tadabbur, where we will recite a few verses from the Quran, and afterwards we will be contemplating and reflecting upon a verse or two that we have read. So let us begin our session first and foremost with Ummul Kitab, Al-Fatiha, in the hopes that it will be a beneficial session and serves as a kickstart to a positive day ahead, insha'Allah. Ala hadhi niyah wa kullu niyatin salihah, Al-Fatiha. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir wajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim, maliki yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. Okay, so for today's session we will be reciting page 114 114 from the Quran, and this page corresponds with Suratul Ma'idah, verses 37 till 41. So if you have your personal mushafs along with you, you may follow along by turning to page 114. If not, you may follow along with the verses that will be displayed on screen below, verses 37 till 41. Okay, let us begin. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يريدون أن يخرجوا من النار وما هم بخارجين منها ولهم عذاب مقيم والسارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أيديهما جزاء بما كسبا جزاء بما كسبا نكالا من الله والله عزيز حكيم فمن تاب من بعد ظلمه وأصلح فإن الله يتوب عليه إن الله غفور رحيم ألم تعلم أن الله له ملك السماوات والأرض يعذب من يشاء ويغفر لمن يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير يا أيها الرسول لا يحزنك الذين يسارعون في الكفر من الذين قالوا آمنا بأفواههم ولم تؤمن قلوبهم ومن الذين هادوا سماعون للكذب سماعون لقوم آخرين لم يأتوك يحرفون الكلم من بعد مواضعه يقولون إن أوتيتم هذا فخذوه وإن لم تؤتوه فاحذروا ومن يرد الله فتنته فلن تملك له من الله شيئا أولئك الذين لم يرد الله أن يطهر قلوبهم لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم. صدق الله العظيم. Alright, so we have just finished reciting verses 37 till 41 from Surah Al-Ma'idah. Alhamdulillah. So one verse that we can reflect upon from the verses that we have read will be verse number 40. Okay, where Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala mentions, "Alam ta'lam anna Allah lahu mulku as-samawati wal ard?" Which means, do you not know that to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth? يُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. It is He who punishes whom He wills, and He forgives to who He wills. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in anything is over all things able and competent. Right. So this verse can serve as a personal reminder and also as a second person reminder. Okay, how does it serve as a personal reminder? When we realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ownership over everything on this earth. Okay. He is the creator. He is our creator. He creates everything. So, He has the power. He has the authority to forgive who He wants. If anyone does sin and does wrong to Him, then He may forgive whoever He wills. And that same particular person, if he does wrong, Allah also has the authority to punish him. So this indirectly serves as a reminder, a personal reminder to us that we should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we sin, okay, when we have done wrong. Because as the verse mentions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has authority and control over each and every one of us, rather everything on this earth. So that is number one. If we do wrong, we should hurriedly turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Him to forgive our sins and ask for His maghfirah. And we should always have the positive mindset that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. Because at the end of the day, Allah is Al-Ghafoor. Allah is the most forgiving and Ar-Rahim. And is ever merciful to His servants. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, from a second person point of view, is that, what I mean by second person point of view is when we know of a person who has sinned. He has done wrong in his life. So we should, number one, not invest our efforts to make him feel wrong, okay? To isolate him from the community. Why I say this is because we can see issues like amongst our community, okay, they have done not so good things, okay, such as taking drugs, taking alcohol, and they have served their sentences in prison, okay, and now they are back out and wanting a second chance. So they have done wrong, they have served their sentences. But from a second person point of view, from our point of view, we should not isolate them. We should not push them further away from us. If not, they will turn back to said things that they indulged in the first place. Okay, so what we should in turn or rather do is to assist them, okay, to guide them towards the right path. Alright, so that is one thing that we can do lah. If we feel that we cannot do that, then the best thing that we can do is to not judge them and help them to be involved in the society more, okay, and not push them away further. Okay, so to summarize from this verse, we can get two takeaways. Firstly, is that whenever we sin from our point of view, we should hurriedly turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His forgiveness, because it is He who has authority and control over everything on this earth. And secondly, if we know of someone who has sinned or has done wrong, we should not isolate that said person further. Rather, we should help and assist and guide them to be more incorporated into the community, so that that person does not fall back into sin and wrongdoing. Okay, let us suffice with that reflection. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our efforts, and I would like to take this opportunity to thank you all for continuing your endless support to the masjid by viewing this video or by viewing other kuliahs too. So thank you, barakallahu fikum, and do continue to support us too by donating to the mosque. Okay, you can find the numbers below via PayNow, fund transfer, or the mosque website, so that we may continue to sustain such programs online, inshallah, for the benefit of the community. Okay, till next time, fi amanillah, fi hifdillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.